misconception. Those deadly habits have me losing my cool. It's what your frame of mind has chosen. I leave your brain stimulated. Misconception. Those deadly habits have me losing my cool. It's what your frame of mind has chosen. I leave your.
Okay. Alright, does anybody know what the name of this place is?
That's Africa. I know that.
That's right, that's Africa. But did you know that Africa is the place where the body of the first man was found? My daddy says that makes it the place where all people originated from. That means everybody's really from Africa. Everybody. All y'all. Everybody.
I'm from Africa. I'm from Crenshaw Mafia.
Like it or not, you're from Africa.
I'm from Africa, you from Africa, you African booty scratcher.
The men sing and sway to gain attention. They flutter their cheeks, cross and roll their eyes and grin.
Before too long, the damage will be
irreversible. Entire villages have been burned. Hundreds of thousands have died. Beatings, rapes, and mutilations are used as weapons of terror.
It looked like water, but it was harder than anything else in the world. He wondered why the gods had sent this thing down to the earth. It was the strangest and most beautiful thing they had ever seen, and they wondered why the gods had sent it.
Rastata! Rastata! Bop, 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 bop! Oregano! You love oregano, poppery!
Good morning, Jamaica. Give thanks and pray.
God to the Most High. Jah Rastafari, King Selassie.
I love going. Any Jamaicans in the house tonight? Oh, good. Finally, a Jamaican that answered properly. Generally, they're like, boop, 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 boop. Trinidadian people are fun because they have that sing-songy accent, you know. You ever just listen to Trinidadian people have a conversation and just, everything is always up and down and ding and ding. I don't know why all those hoes talking and things.
Doing the Ali story, I got a chance to go somewhere. Where did I go? Say it again. Africa. Africa.
This African chick with Eddie Murphy on the skull. She like, Jigga Man, why you treat me like animal? I'm like, excuse me, Miss Foo Foo, but when I met you, you was dead, broken, naked. Now you want half.
When I think about Africa, I think about poverty. I think about AIDS. And I think about warfare.
I said it's a very beautiful country and I would love to go there, but there's also a lot of pain and misery, I know, in Africa as well.
I think that we shouldn't call ourselves Africans, though, because the simple fact is that we're not from Africa. You know what I'm saying?
We're not.
No, we're not from Africa, you know?
And why do you feel this way?
Why do I feel this way? Because I know a lot of us right here was born here, you know what I'm saying? So our ancestors from Africa, you know what I'm saying?
What images do you think about Africa?
The animals and lions and all that.
Well, I know there's a lot and a lot and a lot of grass.
Not really much. I'd probably like to go there, though.
You haven't heard anything in school about Africa?
They don't really teach us anything about Africa in school, and I have no idea
why. What do
they
teach you in school about Africa?
So, does your family like live in trees? Do you guys like have monkeys and lions playing in the front yard like as pets? How do you spell your first name?
Adedoyin.
That's the pronunciation.
I didn't do it?
Great. You know, your English is really good. So you're from Jamaica, right? You sound Jamaican. Yeah, man. You know, you're really civilized. I know you're from a third world country. You have schools there. You like know Facebook, right? Ooh. So in Jamaica, right, does everybody have dreadlocks? Why don't you have dreadlocks? You sound Jamaican. You're not Jamaican? Are you sure you're not Jamaican?
Oh my God! You know this, right? Can you translate this for me?
You guys live in huts. Like, where are your bathrooms at?
I've always wanted to know. Why do you have 16 names?
You have the weed hookup, right? You have the weed hookup, right? I know you have the weed hookup.
I listen to African music. I have Wale's out.
I'm trying to get back at my ex-boyfriend. You can do voodoo, right? I would be careful around her. She's from the Caribbean. She can do voodoo.
Tell me this. How do you say Tanisha in Africa? Y'all eat goat meat? Ugh, that's nasty than a mug.
How did you learn how to speak?
We are going back to a place called home, to which we've never been. That's amazing. To go back home, but never been there though. That's what it's like. Because you immediately connect your spirit, your ancestors, all that is there. It's an amazing story. Save your money and go. It's cost a little money.
While the high-end goods are the ultimate goal, you can still get away with the next best thing.
There's a number of boutiques here and high street stores who have come here. So if you're not able to travel, that, I don't know, $20 dress you can buy here for $12,000 or $25,000.
By far Africa's largest consumers of champagne. The average person in this nightclub spends up to $150 on a night out.
Jobs in the telecoms, banking and services sectors, together with the return of a diaspora who've honed their skills in the US and the UK, have created a social class in between a dazzling elite and a poor majority. Estimate 430,000 households have coughed up for paid-for television. ITV hopes to steal a march on foreign rivals with homegrown programmes like the reality TV show Coco Mansion and Nigeezy, a music channel to showcase Nigerian talent.
This is how Lagos's social elite live. Three gospel choirs, four saxophone soloists, and seemingly no expense spared. But this isn't only the life of the traditional upper echelons of society. Across Nigeria, celebrity culture is taking root. The new socially elite are rich and fabulous.
Shit, like when they were in the club, they played Tupac, they played Biggie and everything like that. But at 12:15, they broke it down. They let me know where the music really started. At 12:15, they broke it down. At what? 12:15, they broke it down.
It's all about choice, yeah.
That rice that I like, I do like a Maggie Cuban spice up your life. She can.